world. My name is Day and welcome to Spanglish Generation. This video is part of a series of videos I've decided to do in English to shine light on the real Cuban experience with socialism or communism or totalitarianism, whatever. You get it. As a Cuban living in this country since I was a little girl, the United States is the place I call home. And it is the place that has served as refuge for Cubans and people from all over the globe who are looking for freedom, respect, and opportunity. I am going to start off by saying that I am not at all a political analyst, nor do I want to even pretend to be one. What I am is a concerned citizen who has experienced both worlds, and that's the reason why I want to take this time to let you know, to explain why we freak out when we see the White House making it rain, honey. Now, I'm not accusing anyone of anything, and I'm not sitting here saying there is a conspiracy on the left driven by the socialist democratic tendency to rend, to place the greatest country on planet Earth under the reins of communism. Well, am I kidding? That's exactly what it sounds like. But I'm not saying at all that's what it is. All I'm saying is, let's keep our eyes open and let's be alert, okay? I am here to make sure that you have yet another perspective that because you may have lived in freedom and this is all you know, luckily, you may have probably missed. People that come from totalitarian regimes can smell it miles away. They can see it coming, they see the shifts in society, the changes in politics, okay? And after escaping one regime and possibly risking your life for it, the last thing you want and need is for this system to follow you wherever you go to ruin your life and possibly the lives of your future generations. So what's this all got to do with the stimulus check? You're probably thinking, why is this bitch trying to get in our bag? Let the government keep rolling out that free cash, yay! While it is important for the government to step in for the people in a moment of crisis, such as a pandemic, you must also be responsible as an adult to understand that nothing comes for free. Somehow that money needs to be paid back. But higher taxes is not my biggest concern, though it does bother me. It's a priority on my list. However, personally, my biggest concern is what the concept of free money does to the people and their minds. Now, you and I know that more than one person used their stimulus check to go on that Disney vacation, okay? Some remodeled their bathroom or upgraded their kitchen, and some have a new Gucci belt and matching wallet because, let's be real, that's all the stimulus check will get you, a Gucci. Free money is not earned money. You tend to waste it on things you don't need because you didn't work your tail off for it. When you learn to expect unemployment, for example, and y'all know some of you have been lying on that unemployment website saying you've been looking for work and you really haven't, I see you. You slowly get used to not doing much and lying to get by. Companies like fast food restaurants and retail have been struggling to find workers because people have been making more money off of the government than via the satisfaction of hard work. Now listen to me, and you know this. When someone fully supports you financially, they own you. In Cuba, for example, medicine is free, they say. Yes, tell me that 3 years ago when I walked into El Naval Hospital in Havana with my mother-in-law and nearly threw up when I walked in the restroom because of the piercing urine smell. Toilets did not flush. There was no running water. Stalls didn't have doors. And be prepared to take your own toilet paper piece or a towel in your purse to wipe yourself because that's not provided in the hospital. And that's the case for all hospitals on the island. Unless you're a tourist, there's a special hospital for you or a high government official. In that case, your bathroom is hooked up. So tourists go back to their country saying what an amazing medical program Cuba has. And in the meantime, back in the ranch, Cuban newborns are sleeping in bedpans, and people are continuing to die because they lack antibiotics to treat simple infections. But medicine is free, so stop complaining, right? In Cuba, education is also free. But you have to study what is available and you must abide by their rules. You can't have your own practice, for example, because in Cuba, everything is government owned and operated. And if you study anything in the medical field, be ready to go to missions to other countries. Oh yes, there's that marketing to the world. You can study, but there aren't any jobs that'll pay enough to live. For example, a doctor gets paid less than $100 a month in Cuba. Can you imagine? But education is free, so stop complaining. Truth is, when you sit around collecting checks here and there, you begin to settle for less and you lower your expectations. America can't lose the entrepreneurial spirit it was built on. If it does, we're in trouble. What we need is a stimulus to work, to get out there and be productive, generate ideas, and of course, generate money. We need the incentive to start small businesses, to develop brands, empires. We need the government to facilitate, promote, and foster financial independence for every American. I tell you this, the United States isn't perfect. There's a lot of work to be done, but socialism is not the way. I have student debt. I don't like it. I think the system needs revision and regulation. Yes, it sure does. However, when I think about what my life would have been in Cuba and I do the comparison, because having a dual experience and growing up with family from Cuba, I'll take the debt. I'd rather pay my own career and do whatever I want with it rather than having the government tell me what I can study and regulate how or if I can use it. I urge you to open your eyes, get educated in the real face of socialism and where it leads, because people want to mask it and, you know, hey, it's good. It's where it leads, not where it starts, not the idea of it, where it leads. I don't want the government ruling my life, do you? We'll really have no choice in the future if we keep taking their money. In the meantime, thank you for watching. And if you find value in the content I post every week, I would really appreciate it if you subscribe and click on that little bell to get the notifications and you don't miss a thing. And also, if you like more videos about the real Cuban experience, let me know in the comment section. And God bless you. Love you guys. See you next time.
When your time comes, don't postpone it. When others doubt and out, you don't condone it. Truth be told, yourself is your toughest opponent. When your moment comes, grab hold and own it. Never let go.